In 1989, I get hired by Scripps Howard to get them into the production business. And I'm the only employee, and I decided the first thing I should do is make sure I'm paid for. If I can do things that'll pay my salary, then other things I want to play with won't cost them any money as far as me. So I got into the news insert business right away. I made a deal with Kiplinger, the financial magazine, to do 3 90-second news inserts a week. Made a deal with Consumer Reports to do 3 90-second news inserts a week. Made a deal with some guy whose name I don't remember, but it was about food. It was a grocer, your neighbor grocer or something. 3 of those, 3 times a week. We supplied them for free to all the Scripps Howard newscasts. And then I sold them around the country to other stations. It paid for me, it paid for my expenses, it paid for my plane fares, and it was successful. And I think I did something else, but I can't remember one of those other news inserts. Then I started working on trying to do some shows. And over a period of 3 years with Scripps Howard, I remember we did a pilot with Tim Reed and Daphne Reed with King World as the distributor out of Baltimore. It didn't work. But the Baltimore people we did it with was Arnie Kleiner, who wound up being GM of KBC here in LA for years and years and years, and his program director, Emily Barr, who is now the president of all the NBC O&Os, I think, one of the O&Os groups. So again, as you move along in your career, you get to know people who, if they're good, wind up having even better jobs. I can't remember what else we did at Scripps Howard. I remember one deal we didn't make. I forgot who it was, came to me. They were starting a new show called Montel Williams, and they wanted to know if we wanted to be a partner. And I said, absolutely yes, but I had to run it by my boss, the president of the Scripps Howard stations, who didn't like the idea. So we didn't become a partner in the Montel Williams show, which I think lasted for close to 20 years. Too bad, but at least my programming gut was still there.